As the leaders continue toward the halfway mark, a second pack follows in their wake, with defending champion Mark Allen wearing number one on his cap, fighting his way through it. Allen knows his strengths lie in the bike and run. For now, he must be content to swim behind the leaders and keep his focus on the clock. The halfway buoy is now in sight, but there is still more than a mile and a half to go.
Welcome back to the Gatorade Ironman Triathlon. The halfway point of the 2.4-mile swim is now in sight, and so is a familiar name. The pace of the swim has been set. Once again, cutting through the water in first place is Germany's Wolfgang Dietrich. It's not unexpected. He's been the perennial swim leader at the Ironman, but his leads haven't been big enough to carry him through. It's been less than 25 minutes since the start, and Dietrich knows he'll need to put at least twice as much distance between him and the rest of the pack before he reaches shore. From below, the race takes on an almost surreal perspective. But on top, it's much different. It's a fight for the early edge. It can't be rushed. The race will truly be won out of the water, but too quick a swim pace can ruin the entire race strategy. So far, so good for Paula Newby-Fraser. Her game plan looks perfect. She's challenging most of the men, but her swim is only half complete, and several women are just seconds behind her wake.
Greg Welch has now made the turn back towards Kona, but he finds himself losing precious time to the more proficient swimmer, Dietrich. Dietrich has overtaken Lorani to take the lead and pushes on ever harder, knowing that this is his best opportunity to extend his lead. Now that Lorani is behind Dietrich, he's begun to draft off of him, becoming a nuisance that Dietrich tries in vain to shake. Greg Welch is steady as she goes, chugging through the water with persistent determination. He breathes every stroke, getting the maximum amount of oxygen for his tiring body. Mark Allen, once a collegiate swimmer, now finds a swimming ability no match for the younger Welch and Dietrich, who are more than 2 minutes ahead. While the men's race continues to surge ahead, Paula Newby Fraser is no question the favorite in the women's race. Fast as she is, though, Paula finds herself in second place behind All-American swimmer Wendy Ingram, who is swimming a strong race up with the faster male swimmers. Dietrich extends his lead over the favorites. His goal is to be out alone. It's a role he's used to as the solitary man.
I'm doing my race. I swim, you know, I have to swim by myself in front. I swim by myself in front, doesn't matter. And I ride my bikes the way I want to do it. Even when somebody passed me, okay, then it's always better when you go with them because it's easier, especially for your mind, just hang in there. But I have no problem to ride by myself for 4.5 hours or a little bit longer.
As the leaders make their way into the swim to bike transition, their focus is shifting from the warm, cocoon-like Pacific to a more threatening and treacherous road ahead. With more on that, here's Craig Masbach.
As the swim nears the end, the triathletes are no doubt looking ahead to this barren, bleak, lunar landscape of asphalt and lava fields where they'll spend most of their long day. This course is deceptive. It's flat and mostly straight, but it's in those features where they find tremendous boredom as the heat sears off of the lava fields. Now, they call this the Queen K Highway, also known as Highway 19 here in Hawaii, but the triathletes know it by another name, the Highway to Hell.
The roads shimmer with the heat of the blazing sun, a reflection of the fire that is the soul of this island, an island forged from red-orange waves of lava. Liquid rock that moves with the inexorability of ocean tides. This is an island ruled by an irritable deity, the goddess Pele, whose dark humors are expressed as earthquakes and whose rage takes form as molten fire. Her legacy? Rivers of lava frozen in time. Obsessed with time are the lead swimmers, Wolfgang Dietrich and Nathaniel Arandi. They know they must press their lead as the transition to the bike approaches.
Welcome back to the Gatorade Ironman Triathlon. A massive crowd has gathered along Kailua Pier to welcome the athletes from all over the world. They represent 48 states and 49 countries. But most of the crowd has no idea who the leader is, since the race so far has been well offshore. But it doesn't take much time at all for it to realize that Wolfgang Dietrich has company. It's Lawandi, and he's turned out to be an unwelcome pest. Less than a minute behind is Greg Welch. There's an extra sense of panic to Wolfgang's transition to the bike. The tone of his race is set by the swim, and he wonders if it was good enough. But with large groups of athletes pouring onto the shore, there's only time to look ahead. Pace of the transition, and it only multiplies when you know others are just seconds behind. And at this stage, stepping into your shoes is secondary. Pedaling is the priority. The name of the game in transition. Keep moving. Tend to details later. Back at the pier, things are getting busy. Greg Welch, still trailing by less than a minute, is also experiencing the strange feeling and jolt of discovering his land legs. All the while, trying to concentrate on not losing his way through the maze of paths of the transition. Still battling the water in a host of swimming, churning bodies, is Mark Allen, nearly